Welcome back to the action. It's the quarterfinal stages of the Viaplay Nordic Dance Masters, all brought to you by the Professional Dance Corporation. Ladies and gentlemen, we're coming to you live from the Forum here in Copenhagen, Denmark, where it's time to meet the players. From England, the winner of four Euro Tours. He's a UK Open finalist. It's Corhan Luke Humphreys! Gentlemen from England, it's time to meet the reigning world number one, the winner of 22 PDC titles, three World Series titles. He is the reigning champion of the world.
Well, as things stand, these two could team up together to make a very exciting and potentially devastating World Cup pairing later this year for England. But today, they are opponents. One spot in the semi-finals up for grabs. It goes to either the world number five, Luke Humphreys, or the world number one, Michael Smith, who is on a quite astonishing winning run. He's won 18 of his last 19 matches, but Corhan Luke, as you see there, four Euro Tour titles last year in that breakthrough year for him. The first year that he started winning ranking events in senior darts, and to be honest, he just did not stop. He is looking to do the same at the start of this year. Get a title under his belt, get on a roll, and then see where he is at the end of the year, because he's already up to number five in the world rankings. That is without winning a big ranking title on the telly. Very impressive stuff. Michael Smith is at the very top of the tree, though. World champion, world number one. And, well, he may be forgetting what it's like to lose a game of darts, because you've got to go all the way back to the end of November for the last time it happened. Blasted his way through the world championship, picked up the title in Bahrain as well. He is on the crest of a wave. Question is, how long can he ride that?
Well, he's there to be shot at, and Luke Humphreys... his chance here. It was the quarter-final from the World Championship we all expected. Ended up Stephen Bunting, who took out Luke Humphreys, who underperformed at the World Championships in terms of his level of play. Great start from Michael Smith. 2022 for both players will be remembered fondly. Luke Humphreys, all those titles, as you said, down the four Euro Tour titles, ranking title as well. Michael Smith, well, what more can we say? Grand Slam champion and world champion, obviously, the beginning of this year. Wow, he's enjoying being the top dog in the sport.
Well, it's going to be quick, this one. It's going to be high scoring, and it could well be close. Luke Humphreys really did look like he'd be playing Michael Smith in Bahrain, but was 5-1 up to Raymond van Barneveld and ended up losing 6-5 in the quarterfinals.
Yeah, whilst that was a painful defeat for Luke Humphreys, it wasn't as if he surrendered it from 5-1. It was more 52. The level of play from Barney was exceptional. It was good yesterday, though, Luke. dealt with the threat of Cantell quite comfortably and deals that opening leg pretty comfortably. Hold the throw. Oh, cool hand.
Did beat Michael Smith on the way to one of those European Tour titles last year, Coulhan, but the bully boy has won the majority of their meetings, as you'd kind of expect. But now that Luke is up at world number five, he's gone from being a player who people expect might do things in the future to a player that people now expect him to do stuff right now. If you're world number five, you should be in the mix, you should be winning things.
And it's a natural progression from Luke Humphries, from Development Tour to Challenge Tour to the Pro Tour to the Euro Tour. 58. We expect TV titles now, major titles for Luke. Threats like this will have to be dealt with. They've met in the quarterfinals of the European Championship. Luke was seeded one in that event, succumbed to Michael Smith. Same format in that stage, 58. First to 10, it was 10-7 on that occasion to the bully boy.
We will be seeing Michael van Gerwen take on Peter Wright in our last remaining quarterfinal. Winner of that one versus the winner of this one. Oh, I like it. Going to the bullseye, then back to the treble 20. Lovely setup shot from cool hand Luke.
Good dart from Michael Smith. Used the guide well. Right opener. A couple of holds of throw.
You think the pace is going to suit both of them, isn't it? They're just going to be on this constant treadmill of visit, then visit, then visit, then visit, and I think they'll enjoy it. It should give them a very good chance of playing their best stuff.
Neither player's going to sort of take a check back, or they're not players who get to a key dart and a double and take that little breather, are they? They just get on with it. And it'll play into each other's hands, in a way. Get a look at the Luke Humphries dart. I'm watching on. And the longest stem. PDC Luke Humphries. We're counting for Michael.
Yeah, smart use of the board of the 19s and the bullseye to get down to a finish. And it means that he's got a chance here. Yes, it's a small chance, but it is a chance. Not going to take it.
Just become the complete player now, Michael Smith. And Luke Humphries is getting there himself. He mentioned the count in there. Just winning scrappy legs, scrappy games. 20. Michael requires 17. Maybe made to pay here.
14s, now the ball. Should have got a dart at the outer ring. It was a slip there hitting the 8th rather than the 16s. But that just finds the corner. It was in danger of busting the score in the double 15. But 2-1 Humphries, all going on throw at the moment.
93. Got away with one there, Luke. That's what you should say. But he had three before Michael Smith got the opportunity. So the leg in that sense went to its rightful owner. You mentioned, Dan, good point in the intro as well, a potential World Cup team for England. There's definitely going to be Michael Smith, Rob Cross in the mix as well. There's obviously, if you get a Nathan Aspinall, a Joe Cullen, in James Wade at the UK Open, if they can win that event, that'll put him in the mix. That will be the big one to sort of put other names in the frame, won't it?
Yeah, certainly. But as Luke has shown, the four Euro Tour titles that he won last year, 25 grand a pop, that's 100 grand winning four of those, and that's the same as winning the UK Open. That's how he's got so high up the rankings. There is money to be made in professional darts nowadays. Michael Smith has certainly made big old chunks of it in recent months. 100. Michael required
90. Bullseye. Had a dart, a ball in the previous leg missed, Luke, and on this occasion, chance here for Luke Humphries. Double 16 for the first break. Ball's inside.
Marco, you require 25.
switches his route around for this. He's going 5-10. And gets it. That's what you would expect him to be, his normal route, but sometimes he will go 9-8. Getting more and more comfortable moving around the board, Michael Smith. You mentioned, Mark, he feels like the complete player now, and that's kind of how he plays the game. Whatever he needs to do, he's capable of doing.
Winning when he's not at his best is another tick in the box that Michael Smith's added, and until you become a major champion. Both players will head to the Masters next week as seeded players. And they've got tough draws. Luke Humphries will face the winner of Joe Cullen and Chris Dobie. Michael Smith will face the winner of Ross Smith or Damon Hetter. How's that for a draw when you're the number one seed?
Ross Smith, of course, one of the few people to beat Michael Smith in the last 3 months or so. From the European Championship onwards, he's only lost three games. Ross Smith in the final of the Euros, Richie Edhouse at the Players' Championship Finals, and David Stretch Evans at a Pro Tour event. He's beaten everybody else, including Van Gerwen and Cross and some of the greats. Look at this. Bullseye for a 1-6-1.
On the last three legs, he's had a dart and a ball to win him. And he's going to return, and it looks like the first breaker throw could be incoming here. Michael Smith 46. To lead at the first interval.
Black we require 39. 19 for double 10. Oh no, 7 for double 16. Again, surprising us with his choice, but delivering. Michael Smith comfortable on any part of the board, and it's enough to take a lead into the first break.
Peter Wright versus Michael Van Gerwen. Talked about Dan, Michael Smith being the complete player. They're not mind-blowing stats, are they? But just finding a way to get your nose in front when you're not at your best. And it's a trait that Michael Smith has been doing a lot the last few months. 31.
There's absolutely no question Michael Smith has played some fabulous darts in the last few 85. Months. Some world-class stuff to become world champion and world number one. But as you say, when he's slightly off, he still finds ways to win. 100. And, I mean, you could argue that the spell he's in at the minute, winning all of these games, he's still not playing as well as he had that spell 5 or 6 weeks through the summer last year where he won five titles pretty much on the spin. He's winning, he's this good, and he can be better. 92.
Look at the leg when he comes out. Luke Humphries has just got to hang in here. The next leg will be big. Well, we expect Michael Smith to get rid of his 38, but Humphries just asked a little question. Straight at it. Humphries can't afford to go two breaks to throw down. We saw Rob Cross go two breaks down in the previous quarterfinal against Johnny Clayton, and it just made him chase throughout the whole match, and eventually it was comfortable for the ferret.
16. Well, that 13 dart is the best leg of the match so far. And when you've got these two, both top five players in the world, coming into the sixth leg, averaging sort of 92, 93. You know they've got more gears. You're expecting at least one of them to start 16. Moving through them. And maybe Luke Humphries is starting to do that. That's his first maximum.
105. You talked about the new attitude of Michael Smith. Well, Luke Humphries has had a good attitude over the, not just last year, the year before as well. The petulance from his game had gone. He's just gets on with it. If he has setbacks, he's head in the game. And
81.
Pulls one low. Well, pulls on wide there. But yeah, it was, I think when he first got his tour card, he took the feats really hard. But since then, just used them to learn. And that's what's made him successful. That's what's made him the world number five.
Yeah, it's the often ineffable but very real benefits of experience. Even the likes of Michael Van Gerwen took time to learn how to win big darts tournaments, and certainly win lots of them. Becomes a habit, and it's one that Michael Smith is very much in at the minute.
Stance of Michael Smith, no movement, slight little Slight walk on the last start.
139.
Humphries. Solid as well. Front on to the board.
59.
Opportunity here for Luke.
Well, move now. Yeah, to the 18s.
38.
Make sure he leaves a finish. A lot of players will start on the 18s, but Luke's choice proven correct there. Michael Smith applying some pressure.
64. Michael 64. Smith, though, may only get one dart here.
Michael requires 62.
Pebble 14. It is one dart, and it's at tops.
22.
So chance for Humphries.
Luke, you require 100.
Great dart, leaves tops. Beautiful. Textbook stuff from Luke Humphries. It's a 14 darter. It is a breaker throw, and we're all square again.
Despite a 180 in that leg from Michael Smith. Done well, Luke Humphries. Controlled the match yesterday against Marco Cantelli. The finishing stats are really good as well. 50%, 98 average. It was a clinical performance.
97.
It's pretty decent from Humphries, but there is room for improvement. This is not really what we expect from Michael Smith, but it is four all. And when you're playing somebody who is world champion and world number one, undisputably at the very top end of the sport, if they're not playing their best and you're only level with them, sometimes you can think, I may have missed a trick here, because he's going to get good, surely.
Key is that he's got level, hasn't he? So you've got to take the positive. Really forceful with that last start, Luke Humphries. Break after 10 legs.
100. Humphries.
Get this leg on the board. He'll be satisfied even if he goes in a five apiece.
100.
Look at the last one, and it offers Michael Smith an opportunity. Maybe just a dart at the ball. It is the ball.
99.
Four attempts at the ball in this match. He hasn't hit them yet, Michael Smith.
Wrong side of that one.
10 score.
And can't find it. And a slap Michael of the thigh in frustration from Cool Hand Luke. Double 10. Michael Smith will not trail going into the final session. The frustration evident for Luke Humphries.
That one will hurt for Luke Humphries. Michael Smith still far from his best, and Humphries had done well to get back on throw. All darts in that leg to lead 5-4. Guarantee that he wouldn't trail at the break, and now he's got his work cut out to get level at the break.
Getting more and more frustrated, Luke Humphries just needs to keep his cool.
Michael Smith is just going through the gears. It's slightly better.
85.
Averaged around 92 in that first session. He's picked it up slightly, Michael Smith, but still expect better. But this for a 6-4 lead. Hit the ball there. At the beginning of a combination.
41.
So for a 6-4 lead.
4.
Those ones you can afford to miss.
Humphries will be kicking himself, but he hasn't scored well enough in this leg. Not within striking distance. He's resigned. 16. That he's going to be trailing 6-4 at this break.
16.
Gets it in the end, and you sense Michael Smith still not overly satisfied with how he's playing.
but
his Welsh teammate later on this year. It's a race to 10 for a spot in the semis to face either Peter Wright or Michael van Gerwen. That is the final quarterfinal coming up. And as you can see, it has not been the highest standard from the top player on planet Earth. But that is his fourth 180. And he inches closer to the finishing line. He got away with one, certainly, in Bahrain. Dimitri Vandenberg let him off massively. He ended up taking the title. If you don't take your chances against this man, he will punish you. And this is a punishing leg, because he's gone back-to-back 180s. The man who hit a 9-darter in the world final on January 3rd is on the 9 again.
We saw Dimitri Vandenberg agonised, he missed out in Bahrain on the perfect leg last week. Can Michael Smith do it here? He can't. Importantly, though, Michael Smith is well on his way to a double break here.
Great shot from Luke Humphries, but he can do absolutely nothing to stop Michael Smith here. Double 10. It's always there on the end of his arm. 11 darter flies out the blocks at the start of this final session of the match. It is another break, and the bully boy has a firm grip on this contest.
Tough on Luke Humphries. That ninth leg was key. That's the lead. Guaranteed in trail at the break, and then all of a sudden, Osprey's double checking. Yeah, all of a sudden, we're sharing a little laugh there. Since then, Luke Humphries has not managed to win a leg, and it's Michael Smith. There's muscles in this match now.
Well, we said earlier, didn't we? If he's not playing anything better than a low 90s average, and you're only level at 4-all, you may start feeling you've missed a trick, and that might be what's happening, because Michael Smith is getting good, and he's getting good very quickly. Just thrown in an 11 darter, he's on another 11.
You called it, Dan. Felt that Luke Humphries had missed a trick by not taking advantage of the below par stats of Michael Smith in that first part of the match. He's just looking to tee up and hopes for some mistakes. Michael has missed this double a few times in the match. This for 8-4.
Double two.
Game shot in the 12th leg.
That might be the biggest change we've seen in Michael Smith in this brilliant winning run. There's no panic. If he misses and misses the last dart, he's given it the best possible chance. The number of last dart doubles he was hitting throughout the World Championship under enormous pressure. And they make a difference.
They do, and they can have a knock-on effect into the next leg, because you're sort of wounded by just marginally getting an opportunity. Humphries just needs to stop the rot here. Four consecutive legs for Michael Smith. He's absolutely thriving now, Smith. That's seven maximums in this match.
And four in the last 2.5 legs.
96.
He has suddenly found his range.
91.
And they both leave themselves the big fish. Luke Humphries cannot take it.
Look for another one of them, though. Yeah, great setup from Luke Humphries. Smith's turn.
Luke require 36.
To stop the rot on double 9.
18.
Can't do it.
Michael, you require one.
Luke Humphries, 50% on the doubles yesterday. In the low 20s now.
86.
Gets another opportunity. 4 from 18. 14. That's missed the doubles, but Humphries does stop the rot. 8-5 he now trails, but he's still a couple of breaks behind.
Well, it's that old cliche, if you can keep Michael Smith two legs away from victory, he'll feel like he's in the game. If Michael Smith can hold throw here and be one away, then Luke Humphries will be forced to win five legs on the spin. There is no margin for error.
Yeah, and Luke Humphries can afford, well, say afford, there's room for a mistake at this stage. But once Michael Smith's at nine, he's got to be near enough perfect from there on in. Big task for Luke Humphries now.
Well, from this position against a player like Michael Smith, you might not make a mistake and you might still lose, because it's very possible that Michael Smith finds a couple of 11 darters on throw, and the only way you stop that is a nine. And we haven't seen a nine darter on the World Series for nearly 8 years.
Gonna get a chance here, Luke.
64.
Might possibly have six at this 1-2-1. Double 17.
57.
Still tricky, isn't it? 64.
167.
If he gets a go, that is, and he's going to.
There's an argument for going to the bullseye with your last start. Somebody like Gerwin Price will often do that, because it leaves a single to double combination. He's only going to get one dart at double. It's double 16.
Game
but one dart is all he needed. That is a break of throw.
15th leg, Luke to throw.
Really
first.
Good from Luke Humphries.
Game on.
Smith, who had a dart at tops on the 106 in the previous leg.
100.
A good response from Luke. Averaging more than Michael Smith.
We saw that from Rob Cross against Johnny Clayton. He still lost 10-4, didn't he?
Johnny Clayton played the big moments better than Rob, and you can argue similar case here.
See quite a lot of missed doubles from both men in this one. It's just that Michael Smith, a number of his misses have been ones where it hasn't mattered, because Luke hasn't been there to take advantage.
Looking like another comfortable leg for Luke here.
Luke require 132.
Options now. Double six.
What do you make of that board management, Mark? Because double six, it can be tricky if you miss inside. He didn't have to do that, did he?
Oh, no, he could. There was plenty of options. Maybe just in a hurry to get the leg done in that shot. But he pins the double six. That's three successive legs for Luke Humphries now. And back in the balance here, Michael Smith drops his throw again. It's advantage Humphries.
That's the best way to respond. 8 180s for Michael Smith in this contest. Luke Humphries has the bit between his teeth. But has he given himself too much to do, having gone 8-4 down? Well, for one brief moment, I think half the people in the forum here thought we were going to see another nine-dart attempt.
Good response from Smith, though. And Luke Humphries is on the charge. Three consecutive legs. He set up a 10-dart leg early, eventually went in 11, but he's done it again here. It's clinical from Smith, and he needed this leg.
96, what we require.
When you've got a lead and you see it shrink and shrink and shrink, it can be easy to panic.
Game time,
but Michael Smith has kept his cool Michael and thrown Smith, in a world-class leg of darts to re-establish his authority and move within a leg of the semi-finals.
23.
A win here would make it 12 games, one in a row for Michael Smith. All the way through the World Championship, all the way through the Bahrain Darts Masters, and a couple here in Copenhagen.
Long time ago when he suffered defeat to Richie Edhouse at the Players' Championship Finals. The winning streak continues, and he's one leg away. Going into a semi-final again. Keen to get it done here and avoid having to throw out the match.
96.
And the averages have climbed as the game has gone on. They're down in the low 90s. They're now up to sort of 95 and 97, respectively. They've got better, and they've got better at a similar standard, the pair of them, as the match has gone on. But Michael Smith has just been finding enough at key moments.
88.
You made a good point, Dan. Excellent point, actually. Luke Humphries, Michael Smith wasn't at his best, and it was four apiece. That's where Humphries needed to make his move.
96.
Match that. Come and gone for Smith.
36.
You expect he'll get more. I'll hold that thought. He may not get more. Great effort from Luke Humphries, but that could be His last darts at the Nordic Darts Masters. Smith for a place in the semi-final.
Double 10. Been so good to him all the way through this match, and Michael Smith relies on it again. He shakes his head. He's not happy. It wasn't good enough, says the world number one. But it was good enough to win a 12th game in succession. The Bahrain Darts Master, the world champion, is through to the semi-finals of the Nordic Darts Masters as this ridiculous winning run continues.